fighting for justice for Imam Luqman. All right? And I don't know about you all, but where there is a threat to justice anywhere, there's a threat to justice everywhere. My name is Reverend Charles Williams, the second pastor of King Solomon Baptist Church. I really feel like that it's important for us to fight this issue that surpasses our religious background. All right? But it digs into more of an issue of human rights. And so we are here today to support an action that we have done today, which is to send President Obama a letter asking him to make sure that he employs and he urges the FBI and the U.S. Attorney's Office to investigate, the Civil Rights Department to investigate this issue immediately. Not tomorrow, but now. We want justice now, not tomorrow. So we are here for those reasons. Also, the co-chair of the United States Social Forum, co-chair of the United States Social Forum. The Social Forum is coming in Detroit June 20th. United States Social Forum, Faith and Spirituality Committee, I might add. The Social Forum is coming June 21st through the 26th. Folks from all backgrounds, faiths, and walks will be right here in the city of Detroit watching us. This is a time, and this is the issue that we need to make sure we have on the table. So when we go down to the McNamara Building, the federal building, when we go around 211 4th Street where the U.S. Attorneys are, when we go over to the United States District Court Judge, we can tell them that it's not just us here in Detroit, but it's folks from all over the world who are concerned about the actions in which Imam Luqman was having. So we got to fight. What does that mean? All of that means is we got to organize. We got to go to work. We got a lot to do. We got to tell all of our friends, our family. We need to pull everybody together that we possibly can pull together. So much so, that baby was excited. That baby is more excited than y'all are. We going to fight. He's ready for the war. So we need to organize all of our different mosques. We're organizing churches and mosques and temples and centers. Everyone who needs to be on this issue, everyone who cares about human rights needs to be engaged in this issue. There's no more time to say idly by. There's no more time to wait a little bit longer. We want justice now. We want justice now by any means necessary.
Assalamu alaikum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Afdal as-salati wa atamm as-taslim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa sayyidina Ibrahim wa Musa wa Isa. وجميع الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى أهل كل وصحب كل وأما بعد. I begin praising and thanking Allah, God, the Lord of the worlds, and I seek His most excellent prayers and most perfect peace upon Prophet Muhammad, and the same blessings and peace be upon our leader Abraham, and upon Moses, Jesus Christ, and all of God's prophets and messengers, their households, companions, and disciples, and what follows. Our Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final prophet of Islam, said, "Afdalu jihad kalimatul haq inda sultan jihad." What is the best jihad, the best struggle? The most excellent jihad, the most excellent struggle is to speak a word of truth and justice to a tyrannical leader. This is the best role. It's not with a gun or with a bomb. It's having the moral courage and fortitude to stand up to a governmental entity and say, we seek truth and justice. And I said that, Shahid, in the context, I'm not calling President Obama Rais Jaber or Sultan Jaber. I'm saying this as to make a point in regards to our spirituality and how important it is within the teachings of Islam to demand, not just ask, but to demand justice. This was the message of Moses in front of Pharaoh, and Daniel when he was locked up in Persia. Jesus, the son of Mary, during the Roman occupation of Palestine, and the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he challenged the injustices in the city of Mecca, where the pagan Arabs would bury female babies alive, where they were involved in slavery, murder, and mayhem. And this is the message to all people of good faith and good conscience. Before I pass the mic over to Imam Sisi and then to Reverend Bill and Reverend Charles, had to give the leave. Earlier today, we had a press conference in regards to a letter that we sent to our President Barack Hussein Obama, urging him to direct Attorney General Holder to launch an immediate civil rights investigation into the homicide of our brother, Imam Luqman Abdullah, rahimahullah ta'ala, may God's mercy be upon his soul. And I just want to update you in regards to this situation of a couple of points. One is that just a few weeks ago, Wayne County Prosecutor Kim Worthy stated that she declined to hold an investigation into the shooting of the imam. Now, Wayne County Prosecutor Kim Worthy is not to blame in this situation. Some people say, well, why is she pointing out she doesn't want to hold the investigation? For the FBI to release their official results, they must have sign-off from a local prosecutor's office. So Kim Worthy requested from the FBI certain information from the FBI regarding the raid. The FBI refused to give Wayne County Prosecutor Kim Worthy information. Now, this is totally unprecedented and ridiculous. Kim Worthy is a prosecutor. She's involved in enforcing law and order. FBI share all kinds of confidential information with her regarding former Mayor Carmi Kilpatrick and Monica and the Senegal situation, all types of situations. So you have a federal law enforcement entity not sharing information with the prosecutor when it has nothing to do with the national security threat. This is unprecedented. Now, Attorney General Mike Cox has hired former prosecutor Doug Baker to hold a quote-unquote independent investigation into the shooting of the imam. This isn't because of Mike Cox having chivalry or him being a friend of the American Muslim community, Muslims of Michigan. He had to do this out of default because for the FBI to wrap up their investigation, they needed a prosecutor to basically investigate and sign off. And because Kim Worthy refused to do it by default, it was then kicked up to the Attorney General's office. Now, we, as an organization, filed a Freedom of Information Act request regarding not only the proxy report, the autopsy report for the dog, but also for potential video surveillance footage in the warehouse. And we have since filed, which We also sent out a request recently to Mike Pack's office.